Hello everyone, it's Jess, and welcome back to the channel. For today's timeless message, whenever you find it, it is meant for you. We are going to be doing a pick a card with an air sign focus, all right? So if you're the Aquarius, the Gemini, the Libras, this one's for you, all right? I'd like to draw your attention right away to the glass birds that I have here, the red, the orange, the blue. Decide for you which one you're going with today. We will be using the Wisdom of the Oracle Divination cards by Colette Baron-Reed. All of that information can be found right in the description box, including links to my Amazon associate links. You can check it out for yourself. I've got a lot of fun things there. Check out the description box if you are interested, and we're going to jump into it. All right. So we are going to start out with my air signs that chose the red bird. All right. You resonated with the red bird. Your oracle message for whenever you find this, because it's timeless, it is meant for you. You need to receive the number 30. Okay. So how does 30 resonate with you in your life? Are you seeing 333 or 3030 or some other number even that time and time again is repeating within your environment? That is a sign in synchronicity. I like to encourage you to go out, do your homework, do your research about numerology meanings, angel number meanings, and find out some additional information that can help you in your journey. Tick tock. How do you resonate? Look at that. All right. The hands of time. All right. Time is an interesting thing, isn't it? Time is created here on the planet, all right? In the universe, time doesn't exist, okay? And we have limited time here in our human suits, don't we? And are we using this time, red birds, to do what we said we were going to do before we came in, all right? Do you feel like you are taking notes from your intuition or your own guidance from your own God, however you want to label that? I'm not here to convince you. You get to decide, all right? Are you taking action based on faith, based on your spiritual team's guidance, okay? Or are you missing it completely? Do you feel like you're wasting your time here on the planet, or you've wasted enough time and you're fed up and now you want to stand in your power, okay, and lead a more authentic life, or start living with more purpose, okay? This clock here attached to the what appears to be a type of balloon, okay, how does that resonate for you? And the color, kind of these yellowy, orangey tones here, how does that resonate? Colors hold energy, colors hold meaning, okay? And spirit loves when I bring up chakras, okay? And there are oftentimes certain colors that are associated with particular chakras, okay? Go out and see what yellowish orange, what chakra system that typically represents, and dive in deep with that. Okay, do some research on that. Spirit wants me to encourage you, red birds. Okay, we're going to dive into the booklet message here. Colette Baron-Reed puts together a wonderful booklet message. She includes a lot of information for different areas of your life that you may be experiencing this tick-tock type of feeling. Okay, so I'm having a difficult time here. Here we go. It was eluding me a little bit there. All right. So listen on in, take what resonates and leave the rest. And as we are reading through this, if spirit chimes in, wants me to deliver some type of channeled information, some type of tip or trick or advice, as it were, take that how it resonates. Might not resonate with any of you, okay? And if it doesn't, that's okay. It's not for you to receive, all right? Here we go. Essential meanings, red birds, timelessness, divine timing, immeasurable time. All right. right. The Oracle's message. When humans created time, everything changed and contracted. People have come to look at life in a linear way, imagining that the past is behind them and the future ahead of them. But what if that isn't true at all? What if everything, creativity, beauty, chaos, and order, were happening now in a glorious timelessness or the glorious eternal present moment? Okay. You have all the time in the world to co-create the life that you desire, so release your agenda. Let go of your need to shape each moment to your expectations, knowing that what is yours will never be withheld from you. Miracles are here right now and always show up when you need them, right on time. Absolutely. Okay. This card, Redbirds, is really offering up an opportunity to reframe how you view time. Okay. Man-made, human-made time versus the infinite time of the universe, okay? And how sometimes we need to let go of our man-made time constraints and allow things to come in divine timing, all right? Relationship message, Redbirds, love, the fulfillment of desire, and even the body's reproductive cycles have their own timetable. Some things are preordained and cannot be coerced. Everything has its season, its divine and appropriate timing, especially when it comes to matters of the heart. Remember that you always have enough time for love, to find it, to nurture it, to give and receive it. Its clock is eternal and ticks according to the beating of your heart. Isn't that right? We are created from love, from high vibratory states of love being the highest vibration. And to love, we do return. However, if we can embody love here while we are within our organic vehicle, that is a beautiful human experience. Okay. Its clock is eternal and ticks according to the beating of your heart in perfect rhythm. Isn't that wonderful to know? Love is always right on time. Okay. Prosperity message. Okay. I was trying to ignore it, but Spirit wants me to bring forward here today that somebody might actually, either you're experiencing it yourself or somebody you know, is experiencing some type of heart rhythm issue, okay? Please seek medical care during this time, right? That is going to be for just a few of you. Take it how it resonates. Take action as a result, okay? Your prosperity message. Redbirds, your prosperity is co-created by your endeavors as they occur in human-made time and the eternal efforts of your most important manifestation partner, Spirit, in a divine, measureless time. So keep doing what you're doing. Stay positive and make a commitment to remain in high vibration thoughts and feelings. If you heed the message of this card, it will seem as if you will align with your highest calling and your highest good in no time at all, like magic. So what's all the fuss about? Not having enough time. The prosperous life that is yours will never pass you by. What is meant for you will find you, okay? Regardless, right? Protection message. Have you been feeling as if the clock is ticking and gotten a little nervous that your dreams are taking too long to manifest? There is nothing to fear. You will never run out of time for the important things. The miracles that are yours and yours alone cannot be missed. Isn't that amazing? You're in such capable hands with guides and angels hovering in visible spaces, ensuring that your journey will be filled with all sorts of goodies. Let your anxiety be gently dispelled by your faith. Spirit will never deny you your highest good. All is yours in divine appropriate timing. You can relax, okay? You can relax, Redbirds, in knowing that it's all gonna work out when it's supposed to. Ooh, wow. That can be hard. It can be difficult to accept that it is what it is. And you've, especially Redbirds, if you've taken the time to be mindful about the thoughts that you're thinking, the feelings that you're feeling, and the actions that you're taking or not taking, and how those things are in your control and everything else is left up to the divine timing. Okay. Ooh-wee. Powerful. All right, for my orange air sign birds.
All right.
Your card and your focus is number 6. So how do you resonate with the number 6? Go out, do your homework, do your research. All right, numerology number 6, life path number 6. There could be messages there for you, okay? And certainly angel number 6. Go out, do your homework, and any other number. It doesn't have to be 6, but that is the orange bird number. Ooh, not for you. Interesting. Okay, we've got a little fortune cookie there, and it says nope. The little message says nope there on a chess table. Okay, there's a door or window there. All right, interesting. Orange birds, it's time to let go what is not for you. All right, my orange bird air signs, stop trying to make specific moves to hold on to something that is not for you, okay? Stop trying to manipulate the situation so it turns out in a different way, okay? Because you feel uncomfortable, you feel it's supposed to be a certain way, it's time to let go. Let's get into the booklet and see what Colette has in store. If you like these cards, if you like these messages, if you like the glass bird, and some other goodies and fun things, check out those description box links, okay? Part of that Amazon affiliate or associate program, all right? So I do make some small commissions off any products that you would purchase by using my links, okay? So consider it there for you to check out. No harm, no foul, no pressure, okay? Just offering you up your opportunities and what's available here on the channel. As I make changes and grow, all right? Not for you, essential meanings, orange birds, a clear knowing that something is being denied you. Rejection is God's protection, okay? Absolutely. Orange birds, if you can view it this way, think about it this way, you're going to be better off for it, okay? The oracle's message. There are times when it appears that no matter how deeply you desire something, no matter how hard you work at something, the result you seek always seems to elude you. It's as if you don't really get to be in the game and you feel you're just watching from the sidelines. The appearance of this card indicates that you are not going to attain what you want right now. That indeed your dreams for the exact thing will not be fulfilled. Okay. That doesn't mean that it won't show up for you. It's just not coming in the exact way that you wanted it to. And that's part of your lesson, okay? That's really part of your lesson here today, Orange Birds, is accepting the ending, accepting the result for what it is, okay? And not missing the fruition because it looks different, all right? This is a time to radically accept that not everything is available to you when you want it. Take heart, for there are benevolent forces who desire the best for you and have a much clearer idea of what is for your highest good. Rejection is God's protection, Take that as your motto, Orange Birds. Something much better that will make you truly happy is on its way. You must trust this process. Relationship message. Some relationships carry an innate seed of failure in them that is obvious from the beginning. But the red flags escape your observation or you refuse to acknowledge them. When a relationship is not meant to be, it is not possible to make it be. You don't want to try to convince somebody to be with you. Okay? That is desperate energy. You don't want to attract a relationship from desperation. Okay? Rejection is a sign that you're being protected by the divine. It's not always easy, okay? But please remember that. If the one who must reject another, if you are the one who must reject another, remember that you do so for both your sakes. For every pot there is a lid, this one may not be the best fit, okay? Absolutely. There are better fits. There's so many people in the world. And the way that technology has been developed, our communication is across the globe, isn't it? Prosperity message, Orange Birds. You can strategize and project and systemize and invest all your time and energy, but sometimes your best laid plans seem to go awry in spite of it all. Keep in mind that no effort is wasted. Fail fast and learn from defeat. Fail fast and learn from defeat. That's what very successful people do. They fail fast, they learn, they pivot, and they go a different direction. You're being asked to do this, okay? Then keep going, right? Just because you quote unquote fail doesn't mean you give up. No way. That rejection was God's protection. It's redirection in a new way. Okay, it's all how you look at it, Orange Birds. You will eventually succeed, although perhaps not at this game, not at this time. Know when to fold your cards. Absolutely. Okay. So, and speaking to the not giving up, okay, so you can fold your cards or stop giving energy to a particular avenue, project, whatever it is, for each of us can be different, and pivot and go in a different direction, okay? Doesn't mean that you are giving up entirely, throwing your hands up, okay? Throwing in the towel, no. It means you might have to take a different direction. Your protection message, don't chase after what flees from you. Don't obsess over what eludes you. Don't bang your head against the wall. There is nothing romantic about what is unavailable. No prize given for torturing yourself. And nothing to be gained by refusing to see the red flags that have been waving since you began your pursuit. Now is the time to walk away. There are other goals, okay? As we're walking away, we still have our sights on other goals or new goals, other loves, other people, other relationship opportunities, other games, other successes waiting for you, okay? Just time to pivot. The way out of obsessing is radical acceptance and surrender. Spirit wants only the best for you. This is a sign that you have something much better waiting for you. Trust the process, Orange Birds. Spirit wants me to talk about if you continue to hold on to that which you are trying to hold on to, not releasing, because you're so stuck on it, having to look a certain way, you're going to miss the next opportunity to pivot, the next path being shown to you, okay? So don't let ego keep you attached to that which the universe, God, your spiritual team, is asking you to release, Orange Birds. Wow, powerful, powerful. And finally, here are little blue birds, okay? For my air signs that chose the blue birds, your oracle message focus is number 27. Are you seeing 2727? Go out, do your homework, do your research about numerology, angel numbers, okay? Exchanging gifts, how do you resonate? All right, we've got a cat here, which appears to be a ballerina with some wings coming out of a gift packaging there. Okay, how do you resonate? Okay. Maybe you just received a cat, right, as a gift, okay? And you're allergic. I don't know why Spirit wanted me to add in that. Interesting, okay. Take it that how it resonates. Let's get into the booklet here and see what Colette had in mind when she created the card, okay? Anything additional I'll be adding in, of course, as well as I receive it from my spiritual team as downloads. Exchanging gifts, essential meanings, bluebirds, the law of giving and receiving, currency, trade-offs, weighing costs and determining value. The Oracle's message, you're entering into a productive and enriching time when a manner of all opportunities are being offered to you. You have everything you need to seize them, yet in order to honor them, you must put in the time, exchange your experience and skills, and commit heart and soul to what you're choosing to pursue. You can do it. You have what it takes to be successful if you align with the law of giving and receiving. You must engage in a dance of give and take, push and pull, doing and being. If you let fear guide your choices, you could deplete yourself or create an imbalance. This is not a time of just do, do, do. Use your currency wisely and be mindful of the value others bring to your life, okay? Relationship message, bluebirds. Love is an exchange of life force energy between two beings. It grows exponentially when it's reciprocated. You must give and receive in order for love to flourish and abundance to flow between you. Spirit wants you to start accepting all the blessings waiting for you, as well as offer the same gift in return, reciprocity. Open your heart, allow it to be filled, let love in, let it flow out of you too. Love is truly yours today, okay? Prosperity message, bluebirds. All your hard work and efforts, your commitment to learning, creating and spending your time wisely, pay off in ways that you may not have anticipated. The gifts of yourself, your time, your ideas, and the energy of your intentions are being reciprocated by the universe, which is sending you signs and signals, might be through numbers like 27, okay? Aligning synchronistic meetings and opportunities to bring you success and more. Everything is an exchange. Keep doing what you are doing. Goodwill comes back tenfold. Wow, this is a very positive message for you bluebirds, okay? Protection message. Be careful what you pray for because you might just get it and then realize that you don't want to face the hefty price tag that comes with it. Absolutely. Sometimes we see other people's lives. We compare ourselves to their lives. We start feeling lack. We want to have what they have, and then we manage to attain something that, you know, we've looked up to, a material possession, a career, an opportunity, a responsibility, and we finally land that, and we realize, whoa, we don't actually like what has to be done in order to keep that, okay? Be careful. You may find yourself in a situation you've always desired, but know you'll have to walk away from or even fail at it, okay? Because you can't or won't pay the dues it asks of you, okay? If you want to be a famous musician, you have to practice your craft every single day. If you want to be a millionaire, you have to be responsible for managing the money and paying the taxes. And there's a whole list more that comes with more responsibility. Of course, we all think, oh, my life is going to get so much easier if I just have, you know, unlimited funds made available to me. Okay. Interesting, because with every change, every level up, every new responsibility, compounding responsibilities, there's more to be responsible for. Okay. Even a windfall bears a cost, a windfall in money. It's okay, though, because Spirit will help you achieve balance over time. Another message here reminds you that being only the giver, not the receiver, plays out in many relationships in your life where you find yourself in victim mode, in a codependent dynamic, or holding on to false sense of control. Interesting. Others may push you to continue to prove yourself. The time has come to distance yourself from this kind of imbalance. Being aware of the need for both give and take is the first step to your true destiny. It's all good in getting better. Not only can you handle this, but you can flourish as a result. Wow. Beautiful and powerful message there for the bluebirds. And as we're looking back for all the birds, let me know in the comments, which bird did you choose and how does it resonate with you? And what action steps are you taking or not taking as a result of receiving this message? I'd really love to know what's going on with you. Let me know in the comments. Please like, share, and subscribe. I appreciate you, every single one of you. Thank you so much for your support. Put your best foot forward and be the best human you can be. Have a wonderful day. Take the inspired action today in the only promise moment of the present. Okay? Let me know what you're taking action on in the comments. I'd love to know. Have a beautiful, beautiful day. Don't forget how divine you are, how everlasting your energy is. Come back again and join me for yet another timeless collective pick a card air sign focus. Bye-bye.